It's the DIY Audio Guy back again with another adventure. Today we have an epic battle. It is the Clash of the Titans. It's the UV Resin Shootout. In the first corner we have the champion, the SMD Sunflash. This product has been around for years and is well known in the car audio community. In the other corner we have the challenger, Solarez. This is the surfboard building champion. Today we're going to find out how it's going to hold up. Both of these products are available on Amazon, so check the links in the description. Let's head out to the garage and check out the test bench. The fiberglass I'm using is leftover material that I got from a friend. It's a very thick woven fiberglass cloth. It's a lot thicker than the chop mat that we typically use in car audio, and it can be difficult to work with. I've made some relief cuts so it could conform to the mold. Speaking of the mold, these are just cheap plastic bowls that I grabbed from the kitchen. If I do a good job with all the masking tape, they won't be harmed in the process, and I'll have them back in the kitchen cabinet before my wife even notices that they are missing. I'm going to lay down some foil. It's also good practice to use some mold release wax. I don't have any, so I'm not going to be using any for this test. But I'm definitely going to want to use some when I build the actual subwoofer enclosure. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you don't miss that subwoofer enclosure build. Everything's all set up. We are ready to go. Now, these are supposed to be low odor products, but they are not. So make sure that you use a respirator anytime you work with fiberglass resin. I'm going to start with the Solarez. It comes in a plastic container that's shaped somewhat like a tub of spackle, which I don't really like because it's difficult to pour out of this kind of container. But as long as you stay away from any strong UV source, you should be able to just dip your chip brush right into the plastic tub. The resin has a slight blue tint, and I found it difficult to wet out the fiberglass. That's probably due to this heavy woven mat that I'm using. I put down a second layer of fiberglass mat and it was a lot easier to wet out. I'm in the garage with the blinds drawn and the lights are on, and the resin showed no signs of curing. One thing to note about the Solarez, it's advertised as a dual cure resin. They claim that you can add catalyst and this will behave just like any other polyester resin. So if you don't have a bright sunny day outside, you can still use this product. Now let's give the Sunflash a try. This is a 1-quart metal can with a screw top. It looks more like a traditional fiberglass can or a can of paint thinner. I like the can better since I can easily pour this into a container and put the lid back on the can. If the lid's on, the light can't get in and it's not going to set up and cure. This resin has a light amber color and it wetted out exactly the same as the Solarez, and just like the Solarez, it showed no signs of setting up or curing while I was applying it in the garage with the garage door closed and the blinds drawn. Now it's time to roll these things out into the sun and see what happens. About 3 minutes have passed and both pieces are hard as a rock. I don't know which one cured first, but 3 to 5 minutes of direct sunlight was all it took for these things to set up. But more importantly, I left some resin on the chip brushes, which have been sitting towards the front of the garage with the garage door wide open. And they've been sitting now for about 15 or 20 minutes. And the ambient light did not have enough UV rays for the resin to set. Now, when I separated the fiberglass from the mold, I did notice that the resin that was down close to the mold was still just a little bit wet, a little bit sticky, and it still smelled. And I also noticed that both products stopped off-gassing shortly after they had fully cured. Hey, let's do a strength test. Now, I'm a great big dude, and I've packed on some extra pounds during the coronavirus lockdowns. If these things can hold up my weight, they're strong enough for just about anything you want to use them for. First up is the Solarez. You're going to notice a crack. Now, that crack may be due to user error. That particular section only had one layer of fiberglass. This is actually the second time I performed this test. The first time I was wearing flip-flops and it really didn't make for a good video, and the Solarez held up just fine in that scenario. Next up is the Sunflash. I did a little better job building this one and it held up a lot better than the Solarez. You'll also notice that both samples had a little bit of a flex to it. The parts that flexed were kind of the flange part that only had one layer of fiberglass, but the part that had two layers of this fiberglass mat did just fine, held up plenty of weight. So the question becomes, which one should you buy? I'm going to use the following five categories to evaluate these products. The first one is strength, the second one is ease of use, the third is cure time, and then the packaging, and finally the price. For strength, both were fine, and I believe both would hold up okay. But in the official test that I did on the camera, the SMD sample did hold up better. And because it's what's on camera, that's what counts. So the SMD wins the strength test. Ease of use was a tie. They were both equally easy to use. Cure time. It's too close to call. Both of them are fully cured within 3 to 5 minutes in direct sunlight. And so they both did great. More importantly, neither tried to set up and cure even when the garage door was open. As long as they weren't exposed to direct sunlight, they seemed to be just fine. Packaging. The SMD wins this one. I just like the can better. That's more my personal preference. It's just easier to pour from the can than it is from the tub, and you can just put the lid right back on. You screw it on, you know it's secure, and it's just a better way of packaging the product. What about price? When I ordered mine, the SMD was about $4 more, and that's not that big of a difference. And the winner is, I think it's too close to call, which is really how it should be. Both of these products are supposed to be the exact same thing, a UV cure polyester fiberglass resin. Some of you might want to buy the SMD product just because SMD is such an important part of the car audio scene. But at the end of the day, I think either one would do just fine. Now, which one am I going to use for my underseat subwoofer enclosure? The only way for you to know is to hit the subscribe button right here so you don't miss the next video. Or if you like, you can click this playlist to see all of the videos that are in the underseat subwoofer project. I'm the DIY Audio Guy, and I'll see you on the next adventure.